transconjunctival eye bag removal or non-incisional laser eye bag procedure. I'm 22 and plagued with serious genetic dark circles and eye bags, along with very dry lower eyelid area, which has made me look very old. I'm looking to undergo an eye bag removal procedure, and I've heard of the transconjunctival eye bag removal, where the incision is on the inner surface of the lower eyelid, and another method which uses laser instead of cutting. I would be really grateful if I could be given some advice and insight which would be more appropriate for my situation. Many thanks.
Thank you for your question. By the nature of your question, I think it's very important to help you understand the anatomy and the process of dealing with under-eye bags. You asked about a transconjunctival approach, and then you also asked about a non-incisional laser approach. So let's begin with anatomy. Puffiness under the eyes is caused by something called lower eyelid fat prolapse. Lower eyelid fat prolapse is a representation of the fat pockets that are underneath the eyes that have pushed forward, creating a bulge. Now, I've been practicing surgeon for over 20 years, specializing in, amongst many things, in oculofacial, plastic, and reconstructive surgery. I have seen a lot of things get hyped, and then eventually we go back to doing things in a more traditional way, including non-incisional approaches to reducing puffy bags. People have tried to make little openings in the skin and try to heat things up from the outside. People have tried something called mesotherapy, which they injected under the eyes. Of course, unfortunately, that led to some pretty disastrous results and complications related to vision. So, understanding that it's a fat pocket, that is like a hernia. And so, there is no non-incisional way to do the procedure. But the procedure is to get to the area of the fat pockets, reduce the fat pockets, or reposition, or do a combination of the two. But when you ask about a laser, basically a laser, such as a CO2 laser, is a tool used to make an incision. You see, in our practice, we use CO2 lasers as well as radio frequency technology, and we do it because we want to minimize bleeding. The beauty of using something, an incisional instrument that reduces bleeding, results in a cleaner field for the surgeon to be able to work, as well as less potential bruising for the patient. So, no matter what approach you do, whether you choose to have a doctor do it using a radio frequency or a laser, there's still going to be an incision. So, what I would probably do for someone like yourself, and this is one more thing for you to learn about, is I would do the transconjunctival approach, and I would use either my laser or the radio frequency. Typically, they're almost equivalent, or essentially they're equivalent. And I would also, to help with the skin quality and the dark circles, I would use something called platelet-rich plasma. Now, platelet-rich plasma is taking advantage of the healing properties of your own blood using cells called platelets. Now, these cells can be separated in a plasma by what we call centrifugation, which means spinning the blood until we separate it. And with this centrifugation, we can actually get the part of the blood that has just platelet-rich plasma and inject it. And so routinely, I will do this, and I find that my patients have an improvement in the quality of the skin and the appearance of their dark circles. Very often dark circles are very genetic, can't get rid of everything, but when there is other inflammatory environmental components, for example, some women who apply a lot of makeup use astringents and rub that makeup off, tends to make the skin quality become more delicate and dry looking, and so helping them with platelet-rich plasma seems to really make a nice difference. So, I want you to understand that regardless of the technique, there's still an incision. It's a matter of doing it, finding the right doctor that works for you, who is very experienced in cosmetic eyelid surgery through the transconjunctival approach, and also maybe consider this other option of the use of platelet-rich plasma to help enhance your result. So I hope that clarifies your question, and I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.